President Obama as well. I think he will be proud of it too. It was great to be here with you tonight. Svako dobro svima and God bless you all. Thank you.
Gosh, after all this, I really do wish I was Croatian. You know, my mom was a school teacher for many years, and that's how I ended up meeting the Dugandzics, and she always told me I taught a lot of Croatian kids, and there was never a bad one. They were all good. And I just want to share one story before we leave about Chris. You know, I listened to what you said about your mom, Chris, and I still remember when your mom died. I was a reporter. You don't remember me, but I remember you, and you have always stuck in my mind. Of all the people I've interviewed, you stand out because I remember you had that great game for Notre Dame, and then your mom died, and they sent me to your house, and I didn't want to be there because it was such a sad time, and I knew you were young, and I was nervous, and my photographer and I were sitting in our truck, and we're like, we really don't want to be here, and we don't want to bother this poor kid, and you know, he might get mad that we're here, and blah, blah, blah. And I still remember we were in the truck, and Chris walked out to the truck and knocked on the window and said, hi. And I'll never forget the love that you displayed for your mom, and also how graceful you were, and how strong you were, and how poised you were. And I knew right then that your mom had to be a very special person. I didn't know that you were Croatian then, but after I met the Dugandzics and got to know the Croatian community and get a feeling of what the people were like, I said, well, yeah, that makes sense. He's Croatian. That's why he handled that so well. And I will always remember you in my heart for how you were that day. So thank you. Thank you all for having this Irish girl here at your wonderful event. And we're going to close out now with Father Grbes from St. Jerome's Parish. I've always wanted to be there. I'm from St. Jerome's on the north side. So thank you, Father.
So I have to finish it all, right? We all love the city of Chicago. And it became my home too. You know, I think I've been to every corner of this city and driven maybe 200,000, 300,000 miles. Been to many families and events. But I would just share with you one amazing thing that still amazes me. When you go to downtown Chicago, and you see the high rises. And I would occasionally go and see the beginnings, how they build this huge 60, 70, 80, 90 or more stories building. And then, as you pass by, you don't see much. And it takes days and days and months, they still build the foundation. You don't see nothing above the ground. And then suddenly, the building goes up, and goes up extremely fast. Then you can build as tall as you want because the foundation is amazing, and it's strong and solid. You heard these stories tonight. You see the book. It is about our foundations. It is what you receive from your family. It is what we try to do in the last 100-plus years in Chicago, building our churches and schools and organizations and clubs, being involved in the community, being active, knowing who you are, and passing this on to your kids. So what I ask all of you tonight, and your friends and families, keep building, and happiness will be yours. And peace will find a final dwelling place within you, now and for years to come. God bless you all and thank you.
te poljubim.